City Talk 105.9.
It is City Talk 105.9. This is Zone Unknown for a Sunday night with me, Roy Basnett. We're talking about cosmic ordering. If you're not familiar with it, I suppose the only way I could describe it would be the power of the universe, the law of attraction, as has been identified by Claire with us tonight. And Mark, who is with us, Mark Rossi, just made a very, very interesting point. Tell us what it was, if you would, please, Mark.
That's on the back of something that Claire said. Claire rightly said that if cosmic ordering had any real significance, then, you know, and everybody pulling for their team, etc., England should have got through to the final.
No, everybody.
Of the World Cup.
I never spoke to anybody who was convinced of England's success.
Well, that's exactly what we've just
said. Has cosmic ordering come into play in a negative way for us here then, last week?
Absolutely. If you find that, I mean, I never recommend anyone buy lottery tickets because there is far too much happening within everyone else's mind in that same way. Also, if you've got a team you're playing against, they're all rooting for the team. You're watching your team and saying, well, they're not very good. You know, so we've got a positive on their side coming to a negative on ours, and it's obvious that it's literally a no-win situation. So, yes, you're attracting that, and this is why you have to always be in a state of expectancy.
Do you know what? I think it's great that Mark's brought this up, because I mean, I'm actually a big rugby league fan, and sometimes when I go to watch a game, if it's a game, if you like, of no, it's not the right thing to say, no consequence, but it's not an exciting game, I don't give it my full attention, and sometimes the team that I support can come unstuck, whereas if I'm really, really behind them, and everybody else appears to be, they play better. Now, some people would turn around and say, well, yeah, crowd atmosphere counts for an extra man in sport, but I've come across this loads and loads of times.
Yeah, the levels of focus and coherence required are very high. Then it's not something you can just do like brushing your teeth, combing your hair. You know, you get on with it, you do it. It's a fact that you have to apply a real, if you count brushing your teeth as a coherence level of 1, we have to apply a level 10 to get what you want.
Right. Let me bring in Rob at this point. Actually, Rob's getting married in the not-too-distant future. Whether or not cosmic ordering might need to play its part there, I don't know. What's your take on this, Rob?
I need some help.
Well, I think we've got a bit of a problem with your microphone there. I don't know why that is. Do you want to jump on Mark's one there?
Yeah, leave it open.
Ah, that's more bad. Then we can hear what
you're
saying.
Hello, Steve.
Hi, Rob.
Hiya. Other examples of what we're talking about here could, I mean, the power of prayer, for instance.
Well, can I just say this, and I don't wish in any way to be disrespectful to religion, but cosmic ordering was around first. And the prayer, the hand prayer position, is the crown chakra activation, if you like.
Yes, you often see that, don't you, that image?
Yeah, well, that is taken literally from, if you like, the old Wiccan and pagan, which basically is a sister side of cosmic ordering because of the, if you like, the manifesting side. Mm-hmm. But the prayer, the hand prayer position, was nicked from cosmic ordering.
No, I don't think you're being offensive. By saying that, because many religions have, if you like, I'll use a softer term, borrowed certain kind of attributes from other religions.
Borrowed would be better, thank you.
Yeah. The question that I've got to ask here, there, Steve, is, what is it? I mean, what are we talking about? I mean, are we talking a bit of a Star Wars kind of thing here, like, may the Force be with you? Is that what cosmic ordering ultimately is?
If you perceive it to be that, it can be anything you want. It can be watching a tree grow, it can be seeing a baby being born, it can be blowing out a candle on a birthday cake, any of those and more.
Let's be a little bit controversial for a second here, then. If it is the case that potentially being in a position where you can control reality, what about people who've had tremendous upheavals in their life? They've experienced tragedy. What are we talking about? Are these people just not getting the universal thing, the universe, cosmos thing?
Can I just say, firstly, I do not subscribe to those exponents who say that you get what you wish for. Not for one moment, because I've been in a negative state of mind. You have to pull yourself out of it. But briefly, we think, oh, I hope I don't catch measles. Oh, I hope I don't catch you cold. Well, every time you've said that, you've never caught a cold, you've never caught the measles, you've never got the mumps, so I hope I don't, and it never happens to you. So by saying it doesn't necessarily mean you're attracting it to you. What I'm saying is that your low vibration frequency within, that is the cause of it, and you must always have an air of expectancy and raise that vibrational level. If you notice, a lot of people who are ill, they tend to be down within themselves, but they were down within themselves maybe beforehand. I'm not saying the guy who was laughing and joking and dropped down dead from a heart attack, but there are, we cannot, if you like, breach the laws of nature. We can bend them, we can use them to some advantage, but the law of nature says that life goes on, we procreate. Mm. And we make a better race, a better breed, a better tree, a better blade of grass, a stronger blade. The weak blades of grass fall and leave way for the stronger ones. Mm. And that is the law of nature. Look at what's happening in the Gulf at the moment. Nature's having a bit of a bite back, saying, hey, you've took from me and now you want it, here you can have it.
Mm. Right. What are we talking about in particular there, Steve?
Well, we're talking about the universal law of justice. Hmm. That prevails regardless. We right. cannot prevent that.
Right. So, obviously, with this particular subject that we're talking about here, cosmic ordering is the term that you've applied for this here. We can't support this with evidence in terms of science and stuff like that, but if people wanted to carry out their own research on this and they wanted to find out more, what would they do? Give me the basics of what people can do in order to understand this process.
Well, what they can do, firstly, is go to cosmicordering.net.
Right.
Or they can come on one of my Cosmic Ordering Foundation courses. In fact, I'm holding the nearest one to you, Manchester, in September on the 10th, 11th.
Well, I think that which might pay a visit to you.
So
you
they can come there and find all about it. And literally, they can start very simply. There aren't any prerequisites. You don't have to wear a robe and shave your hair off or buy one of my books or audios. Far from it. In fact, I usually advise against that. I say, look, if you want to delve further, look within yourself. Are you a positive-minded person? Are you an optimist? Have you an air of expectancy? How much really do you want this to happen for you? And if the answer to all of that is a positive yes, 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 that I'm the double glazing salesman asking these questions, getting the customer to say yes, fine. If they come up with an objection, the last thing I do is overcome that objection. I then say, right, look into yourself and find the answers. Speak to your higher self. I usually end up talking to myself when no one's looking because I don't want to be certified as mad. Mm. And I ask myself, look, I'm in a bit of a dead end in my life here. What can I do to change it? Wait for the answers. And I usually say, sleep on it.
And how do the answers manifest themselves?
The answers manifest from the creative side of your mind. And the creative side of your mind is what gives us, if you like, the impetus, the coherence to work with what we desire, to work on getting it to happen.
Well, I've got to say, Steve, I feel a little bit uplifted as a result of our conversation here, so hopefully we'll be able to pop over and see you later in the year. And just remind us again, if people want to check out your website.
It's www.cosmicordering.net.
Steve Richards, thanks for speaking to us on Zone Unknown.
Thank you, Roy, and thank you to your friends, my friends in the studio, my friends in Liverpool. And let's have a great day.
Zone, 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 zone. Unknown. Unknown. On City Talk 101.